You're the man. Let's go. Right, you're the boss.
All right, come on up, everybody. My colleagues, our leaders, come on up.
Good to see you again,
sir. Okay, we ready?
Should we wait for a tester?
Yeah, where's John?
He's coming.
Is he here? Should we wait for a tester? And Moran is supposed to come too.
You can start, Chuck.
You want to start?
Yes.
What do you say?
We have a lot of speech.
Okay. You know, every so often, folks, America lives up to its ideals. And those are days that we savor. Well, today, finally, at long last, America lived up to its ideals by saying to our veterans who have been exposed to toxic chemicals from burn pits, we have your back, finally. No more, no more will veterans go to hospital, VA hospitals and be told, get a lawyer, go find some arcane, ridiculous proof before we'll give you help. Now they'll get the help. And I have to say this, this would not have happened. We senators, all of us, and I want to particularly thank John Tester and Jerry Moran, we senators were instrumentalities in this, but it wouldn't have happened without the steadfastness of our veterans who said, we demand our rights, we're going to get them, and we're not going to stop till we achieve victory. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Wouldn't have happened without them. And they stayed here since, was it a week ago?
Last Thursday,
Rosie was there in the heat, in the rain, because that was nothing like what so many of them and so many of their colleagues experienced from the cancer and all of the diseases that were caused by these toxic chemicals. But they were there as a beacon to all of America. They said, we're not going to let you forget us. We're not going to let you walk all over us. We're not going to let you ignore the suffering that we have faced. Let this not happen again. The good news about this bill is, not only does it deal with the burn pits or the Agent Orange, but all of the other kinds of toxicities, and the VA will no longer be able to say, you got to prove this, you got to hire that, you got to do this. The proof will be already there. So I want to thank again our veterans groups. I want to thank all of my colleagues. This was a bipartisan effort. Jerry Moran is here. Thank you for being here. And let us not ever again forget our veterans like they were forgotten when it came to burn pits. And now I want to call on Jon Stewart, our great chair of the Veterans Committee.
Thanks, Chuck. Thanks, Chuck.
Shut up.
I'll do my best. I'll make this quick. We've been here how many times? More than I got fingers on my left hand, I'll tell you that. And I will tell you, we got this done, folks. We don't have to do this again, okay? All right? Couple observations really quick. Number one, I've never seen so many veterans with tears in their eyes and tears in their eyes of joy that I've seen in the last hour. And the second thing I would say is I just got off the phone with the President of the United States and he said, thank you. This takes a big weight off of my shoulders. And he's the guy who started this ball rolling. So I just want to say, we got great senators here and we got great directors of VSOs here and they've done such a great job making this come to fruition. But one of the things that really, and look, I stood out here on this plaza and I watched you guys that were sleeping out here in the middle of the night when there were thunderstorms and hotter than hell during the day, and you guys made it happen. I can't thank you enough. And I will tell you, when we came out here last time, it was a morning press conference. It was after the vote on Wednesday night. It was Thursday morning. I was feeling low, really low. And I walked away from this microphone and the woman may be here. Turned around, was it you? She turned around to me and, what's your name?
Jen.
Jen turned around to me and said, we're gonna win this. We've been in fights before and we're gonna win this fight. And by God, you did it, all right? Did it. I just want to tell you that there's a lot of times it doesn't feel good in the United States Senate.
Right.
It feels good right now. 86 to 11, folks. 86 to 11. I want to bring up Jerry Moran. Thanks, everybody. Thank you.
Look, the people I admire the most are those who served our country in the military. There's one exception to that, and it's the people who served our country in the military who now spend their lives serving other veterans. And this experience adds a second exception, the family members of those who served our nation. There is no group of people that we ought to honor and esteem more in this country for the benefits that we have as American citizens than those who served America as military men and women, those who came home and went to battle for others who served the country, and all of you who are family members of those who did. I've learned a lot in this experience of getting this piece of legislation passed, and it is the example that you gave us, which is there is no turning back, there is no giving up. We are in this until we achieve the goal that we're after, which is to make certain that those who served our country receive the benefits and receive the health care that they earned and they deserved. You all make me proud, but more importantly, you represent America and make all Americans proud for the success that you have accomplished. I appreciate my colleagues behind me and throughout the Senate who voted tonight in support of this legislation and got us to the point we are. And it's been I can't say a pleasure, that word almost came out of my mouth automatically. It's not been a pleasure working with Jon Tester. But it has been a successful combination to see that the end result is something you all wanted us to achieve. Congratulations. Thanks to the United States Senate for demonstrating when there's something good and a good cause, this place still works. God bless America.
If anybody exemplifies the heart and soul of this movement and the indomitable success, it's Rosie Perez. Rosie.
Torres.
Torres.
Years ago, my husband and I, we rolled our luggage down Capitol Hill. We had no idea what we were doing. We just knew that God had put something in our hearts to carry out. And we came here with the hopes that we could have faith in our congressional leadership. And today, that's what I saw. Today, what happened here, history is being made by these leaders right here, right behind me. So I want to thank each and every one of you, sir, for having faith in us, for standing up for what's right. But most importantly are that the people I want to recognize are the veterans that didn't go home, the ones that walked the halls for 13 years. We walked the halls, we sometimes wanted to go home and had to tell each other, put your big boy pants on, we're not leaving. They told us to build systemic momentum, we did. And we did it for all of the fallen that are not here. This is for Wesley Black. This is for Heath Robinson. This is for Will Thompson. This is for Kate Thomas. This is for all of them. Yes. Yes. For Gina Cancellino and her family. Her husband's not here anymore. It's for your girls. You don't have to beg anymore. You're going to get help, Gina.
Yes. No,
you're getting, Gina's going to get her benefits now. I want to thank Tim Jensen from Grunstyle. Tim, come here. Will Wisner. For a long time, people shut doors in our faces and they said, go build systemic momentum and come back. And I said, well, what do you want us to bring? A list of dead veterans, faces of dead, like, what is it that the Congress wants to convince you that they're sick and they're dying and they're begging for help? So I thought outside of the box and I said, let's go to some veteran entrepreneurs, some people with a platform. And we went to Tim. And Tim said, heck yeah, I'll print up some flyers and put them in all our t-shirt orders. And we created a movement. We mobilized and we organized, and here we are today. We sat on the steps, and that was Tim's idea. Tim said, we're not leaving, Rosie, even if it's just us three. We karaoke'd. Somebody from Canada delivered Crown Royal. It was a crazy, crazy night. But thank you to these senators right here that believed in us. They believed in their constituents, in their people, and they didn't turn their backs on them. So this is for all of you. God bless all of you. And John, wait, one more time. One last thing. Most importantly, Jon Stewart and John Feel. Let's fucking give it up for them. Yeah.
I love you, John.
I was watching the news and I saw them on TV and I said, I gotta call that guy. Those two guys right there, that's who we need to find. And they said, well, yeah, just call John Feel. He answers his phone all the time. And he's like, John fucking Feel, what do you want? And I said, hey, can you help us? He's like, let me talk to John. They didn't hesitate. The way they didn't hesitate with 9/11, the way they didn't hesitate to go into those buildings, Joe McKay, they said yes. And they're the reason why we're here. God bless you guys.
The two Johns, come on up.
John.
Let me just say that I think the turning point of this occurred when last week, in their anger, they let the world know what had happened. And that put the pressure on people to turn their votes around. Thank you.
Potty mouth.
Speech!
I want to apologize for cursing last week.
No, you didn't.
I don't know what happened. No, normally, I'm very demure. Leroy, my brother. Talked to Leroy 4 years ago in my office.
Get a couple pictures.
And I made a promise to him. I said, I'm not going to let you go, my brother, and we're going to get this done. And guess what? We got it done. And Rosie and Leroy are...
We love you, Leroy.
Love you, Leroy.
That's Leroy. But I will say this. I'm not sure I've ever seen a situation where people who have already given so much had to fight so hard to get so little. And I hope we learn a lesson.
That's right. Thank you.
Never again.
I can't apologize for cursing. You know why? Because back on June 16th, we passed a bill 84-14. Today, we passed a bill 86-11. What the fuck happened for the last 6 weeks that we're here again today? That these people had to sleep outside in the rain, in the heat. I love you guys. I love you. But what the, that the GOP Senate made these people suffer more than they had to suffer. I took no joy in cursing last week. I take no joy now. The only joy I get is that I beat the Senate again. Again.
All right, John. You're a professional Senate leader.
What have we become when we lack empathy? What have we become when we don't care about another human being if they suffer, especially veterans? They're inside right now in an air-conditioned room. These people, if you smelt them, I love you, but man, you had some serious stink going on, girl.
3 days outside.
Didn't even have any clean clothes.
Where's the where's the celebration that we're gonna have? The hard part hasn't begun. Getting a bill passed is easy. You just gotta beat up the Senate of the House. But these people behind me now, they actually have to advocate. They gotta take that bill from its infant stage and make sure the Congress and the VA and the Senate do the right thing. They gotta do that for the rest of their fucking lives. I'm still doing it for 9/11, 21 years later. There's no joy in this. But it's the right thing to do. You know, my dear friend Ray Pfeiffer always used to say, and I miss Ray dearly, John, always do the right thing even when no one's looking. And I would argue with my dear best friend, and I would say, Ray, always do the right thing when everybody's looking. Because it causes a ripple effect. And to America, anybody with an issue, get in the face of these people. Make them work for you. I love you guys.
Thank you.
We love you.
Senator Gillibrand.
This has been a heavy weight. All the families here have been carrying this weight. It's been very hard on them to not have their country have their back, to not have their country care enough to make sure they got the health care that they've already earned. And this has been a struggle for decades. It's not a new problem. We saw it with Agent Orange, we saw it with Blue Water Navy vets, we saw it with anybody who cleared up a nuclear site, anybody who cleared up a toxic waste place, anybody. And these veterans show up. They show up for one another. They're tireless, they're fearless, they never give up. They're the best of America. And so this is a day to celebrate because it's a day that Congress actually worked. Yeah. And it worked for the people who deserved it the most. The men and women who put their lives on the line for this country time and time again, never ever complaining and never giving up. So I just want to thank Senator Schumer, Jerry Moran, John Tester, and my colleagues here for being with these veterans, for just listening, hearing your terrible stories, lifting them up, using this platform God has given us to be the person in the room to do the right thing. So thank you. God bless America. Thank you to everyone here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We love you.
For all of us on the Veterans Committee who work so hard and whose faith in the veterans who advocated has been affirmed, I know we have tears of joy. But in my heart, there are tears of sadness. For Peter Antiojo of Glastonbury, who died, for all who have perished already because we waited. Peter left behind Amy, his wife, his son Mark, turned 7 just recently, when he died of glioblastoma, the result of his exposure to burn pits in Afghanistan and Iraq. I have a message to the VA. You better get it right.
Yes, that's right.
You better deliver. These veterans have waited already too long. Yes. The 3 days here are emblematic of what we need to avoid going forward, and the VA for too long has been part of the problem, not the solution. There's a principle that all of us who went through basic training learn. You leave no brother or sister behind.
That's right.
You leave nobody, no matter what the hostile fire, you leave no veteran behind. These guys decided they weren't going to leave anyone behind, and the country is better for their courage, their resilience, their resolve, and they are the best in America. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Senator Graham.
Thank you.
Susan came to me from Sandusky, Ohio, several years ago and talked about her son-in-law who was sick. Her son-in-law is Heath Robinson, as you know, the Heath Robinson PACT Act. And Susan, since Heath's death, has worn this jacket.
I wore it before.
And wore it before
he
died.
For 5 years.
For 5 years she's been wearing this jacket. And on the back of the jacket it says, Specialist First Class Heath Robinson wore this uniform in Iraq. Ask me why he's dead. Vote for the SFC, Heath Robinson, honoring our PACT Act. So Susan is one of the heroes, as is her daughter Danielle, and from Ohio, Tim and Andrea and James and so many of you that have stepped up, thank you, Tim, and made a huge difference. And as everybody up here has said, it's the people, it's all of you that made this happen. We voted, right? Some it took longer than others, but a new president, a new Senate, and the kind of pressure that the VSOs put forward, but all of you individually, family members, service people, thanks for being heroes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Love you. Senator Martin Heidrich of New Mexico.
I want to thank all of you who've been camped out here for the last week in the heat and the rain, not only for making it possible to get this done, and let's be honest, none of this would have happened without your dogged determination and work. But you showed America what it looks like when our Congress works again, when our government does the right thing. This is the example. This is the way it should work all the time. So thank you to all the vets who are out here in the sweltering heat. Thanks to the VSOs who had their back this whole campaign. And a special thank you to all those senators who voted the right way every single time.
Thank you.
Well, in conclusion, the folks behind us said they wouldn't go home until we pass this bill. Tonight, they can rest easy as they go home. We love you. Thank you. God bless.
Congratulations.
We did it, America.
Yes, I want to say one last thing. I want to thank all of these veterans organizations that worked their asses off to make this happen. Come on, guys. VFW, American Legion, DAV, Wounded Warrior Project, Reserve Organization of America, Military Officers Association, all of these organizations, they fucking kicked ass and they made it happen.
Yeah. Well said. Yeah. We love you all.
Well said.
On June 16th, I made a mistake. I called the PACT Act a done deal, even though it had to go back to the House for reconciliation, but we knew it was going to pass. Well, then that little blue slip issue came up. But anyway, on June 16th, I retired Heath's Army jacket.
You get to retire.
But today, now I get really to retire can. For good.
Woo! Well done, Susan!
Yeah, take off!
There we go! Well done!
Susan, you did it. Yeah. You did it.
Yeah.
Say thank you to everyone, from the media that supported us, to all the VSOs, the senators, the Congress members. This was a promise Heath made me promise him, was that I would carry on his story to help these other veterans. Heath felt fortunate. He was dying of stage 4 lung cancer, but he was fortunate because he was active duty. So he was cared for. So this bill does not benefit my family at all, but I'm just thrilled today that it passed because we don't want to see another family suffer like ours did.
Thank you, everybody. Put them up.